How do you come up with a cool name for your YouTube channel? Well, Amieva, I run 4 different YouTube channels, and every time I create a new channel, I need to come up with a new name. In this video, I will show you all the tools I use and give you some extra tips, and at the end of this video, I will also tell you the biggest mistakes to avoid when naming your channel. So first of all, when you start from zero and don't have any brand name yet, I would strongly suggest you to think much more wider than just a YouTube channel name. Think of your website and social media accounts as well, and if you are really serious and want to put all your efforts into YouTube, especially if this will be your personal channel, you need to create your brand vision. When you have an idea, check if your website domain name is available and if the social media account names will be available as well. You can think even more further how this name would look on a merch. You might be saying, hold on, I am just thinking of trying out YouTube to see how it goes. Well, fair enough, but if you don't give it all and don't set your mindset right from the beginning, do you think you will be on the right path? So, well, that's a topic for another video. So let's get into process of creating your YouTube channel name. Tip number one, your channel might be already have a name, and that's your name. Especially if you are doing a personal channel like Peter McKinnock, James Charles, or Tony Robbins, and so many more. These are just some of the examples. If you are planning to run a faceless channel, I will cover that in just a second. So if you use your first and last name as your YouTube channel, you can then grow your brand around it regardless of what you are doing now and perhaps will be doing later. You will not need to rebrand even if you are changing niches. It's the easiest method to use your name. But at the same time, it can be the best one for a personal brand channel. So people will get to know you for who you are and then only what you are doing. And that's a great way how to build your legacy. There might be a downside of using your name if you are into a particular niche and targeting a very specific audience. Your potential viewers will not going to know what your channel is about by just looking at the channel name, okay? So you need to pay extra attention on how to write the channel description, design the artwork and title your videos to display clearly what your channel is about. Now, tip number two, use brand name. If you plan to run a faceless YouTube channel, this method won't work. So let's have a look on how to come up with the actual brand name. Some sort of creative name for your channel. It can be also used if you are showing your face but do not want to use your name. And I will cover the tools you can use to help you out in the next couple of minutes. Okay, when you are using a brand name, you have the freedom to make it as memorable you can and also the ability to include your niche. Therefore, once somebody sees your YouTube channel name, they already know what your channel videos will be about. So let's look at some examples like Project Life Mastery or Epic Mealtime or 5-Minute Crafts. So you get the idea of what to expect from this channel when you are only seeing its name. You can also combine and use your first name and then the topic of your niche. For example, it could be something like Beauty with Betty or Fetty's Fitness. Or it doesn't have to start with the same letter, but it will sound sticky and memorable if you can make some sort of a rhyming pattern. So for example, a channel like Bright Side doesn't tell you what this channel is about, but it's super easy to remember it. So think of some of your favorite channels and how you could use the formulas they use to name their channels. What words could you plug in to come up with your own channel name? Tip number 3, use tools. All the tools I will mention are free, no subscriptions are needed, so anyone can use them to generate an excellent YouTube channel name. So first of all, my ever favorite website is called thesaurus.com, which essentially is just an extensive dictionary. I actually use this website quite often to find synonyms and antonyms of the words. You know, times when you are writing a piece or trying to come up with some name and the right word is just missing from your brain. Well, this website can help you to find it. So for example, if we type word make, you can see loads of similar words instead, and then you can click on one and see more further suggestions until you find what you are looking for. Next website you can use is called brandbucket.com. The site sells domain names, but it's a great resource to find out inspiration and name combos for your YouTube channel. So you simply enter the name you would like to include and you will get a bunch of suggestions and ideas. Similarly, you can also use a website called namemesh.com, nameboy.com and busternamecom. All are essentially working the same way, but you will see different suggestions based on the term you have entered. As I mentioned before, you need to think bigger. So while you are using these tools to come up with the name, you need to check whether the domain name with the extension.com will be available, or perhaps .co.uk if you are UK based like me. You need to think out of the YouTube box and think of your online business where YouTube will be a big part of it, but it can lead you to much more. Before we move on, I click the like button if you feel you are getting some value out of this video. For more videos like this, videos that let you learn more about making money online and making money on YouTube, click the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. Okay. Tip number 4, avoid common mistakes. Check if this name already exists. I know it sounds like, do you really have to say that? Well, you might have spent lots of time coming up with your cool name and are very sure it's unique and you haven't heard that before, okay? Ask Google first before you go for it. Type it in Google, type it in YouTube and other social media before deciding to go for it. If you do unfortunately find the name already ranking on YouTube, or it has established a business that comes up on Google, you might only need to make some minor adjustment to be able to still use it. Please don't make an end of the word of this, yeah? Go through the tools I mentioned before and swap things around. You need to check all the social media accounts as well. And of course, you can see people having different names on YouTube and then different names on Facebook pages or Instagram accounts. But it's better for the long run if you keep all the same if you can. It's just better, more solid start of your online business. Another great tool you can use is called namecheck.com, which allows you to search across multiple platforms to see the available ones, including the domain names. You type your desired name and then green display tabs will be the ones that are still available. And this tool can save you time by going manually checking every social media platform and domain provider. The next common mistake is to use numbers. Numbers within your channel name or social media name will not look professional, okay? It's like when you are creating your Gmail account and you can't use John Smith as your username, but Gmail offers you johnsmith2345 and you go for it. Whatever you are doing with this email, and that might not be a problem, having numbers included on your channel name and on your social media will look like you really wanted this name, it was already taken, but you still went for it instead of coming up with something more unique that doesn't require any added numbers. I think you got my point here. Unless the numbers are a strategic part of your brand, like 99 problems. The next mistake is a name that is hard to spell and pronounce. It just goes against on what we discussed before. Your channel name cannot be sticky and easy to remember if it's difficult to spell it or say it. Your name has to be easy to share without spelling it out for someone to remember it. Once you have picked out your YouTube name, you can now attend free training on how to start your YouTube channel in the right way so you can get monetized quickly and grow your channel's audience in no time. I will leave the link to the free training in the description down below. Okay, the next step for you is now to get your first 1000 subscribers, and you can do it by watching this video right here. Thank you so much for watching, and click that subscribe button if you haven't done it yet, and I hope to see you in my next video. But right now, go ahead and watch this one.